okay, this is part duh of part duh, because Gianna said something very inappropriate in the last one, and we had to stop the video. How about it? It wasn't me for once, it was her.
Maybe if he kept his rooster in his pants.
Shut up. We gotta start from the other part.
Anyway.
Okay, so, the whole Aria Connor, the whole Aria Connor situation. Yes, did he run and tell his friends that he, you know, he hooked up with her, whatever? Yeah. Was he a little asshole for it? Yeah. But I think Aria could have avoided that situation if she wasn't so freaking damn rude to him before he left. Like, he's young. He kissed her. Was it right for him to do that? No. But did Aria have to be like, I'm not you there. Excuse me, I am so not interested in ya. And then show him the friggin' door? No.
I don't recall her saying it that way.
No, but she did. She had a little
it
attitude.
It didn't give him a right to like, call her a slut, though.
I know, I but she was so rude to him,
face.
Though.
I understand
I
that.
Didn't say that what he did was right. I'm not saying that. If you people out there in YouTube land understand what I'm saying and can comprehend the things that are coming out of my mouth, then let me know. Do you understand
Listen,
what I'm saying?
We
they were both at fault. They
we
were both
understand.
At fault.
No, no. He was way more at fault than her. She turned his ass
line.
Down.
He was absolutely out of line. Okay, but it's not like he kissed her once and she said no and then he did it again. He gave her a kiss. All she had to say to him
was
like...
You gotta be cruel to be kind, kid.
No, all she had to say to him was, oh, I'm sorry, like, I'm not interested in you that way. Like, I apologize. Like,
you can tell she hates Aria. Next subject.
Whatever. Well, we already talked about what. Did we already talk about that? Yeah, we already did.
Yes, we did.
Why the freak? Why? Mona?
Mona? Maya New? All right, off we go to find Grunwald.
Mona. Miss Aria, you're a killer, not Ezra's wife.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you're welcome. Why does Hannah's dad want her to admit so bad that she killed him? I think we already went over that.
I believe we did.
Little fuck. That's what I have written down on my paper. Little fuck.
Rooster.
I'm talking about Connor.
Rooster.
Okay.
Cock-a-doodle-doo.
Spencer and Toby go to find Grunwald.
Boy, she was a creepy-looking freaking freak. She had, like, weird eyes. Like, eyes that you would see in a possession movie. Something like The Exorcist.
Don't you think it was a little weird? Now, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that it was a little weird. The timing was off. Don't you think it was a little weird that as soon as Toby left... Somebody came driving, like, around the car, like, to pick Shauna up in Jenna's car, but we didn't see Jenna. Like, I just think it was a little weird the way it happened. Like, Toby disappeared, and then he came running around the corner at Spencer. Like, something was up with that. That was a little weird. That gave me the creeps.
That whole town gives me the creeps, hence
Why?
I can't wait till
okay.
October.
It was so weird. If you go back and rewatch, okay, besides Spencer's car... Every car on that block was an old-ass car. Old.
Yeah,
except
what the
for
hell
one
was
car,
up
it was
with
an
that?
Alero. One car was like a silver Alero.
But, like, the first car you see driving down the street is like a 1950s automobile.
Yeah, they're
and
all
like,
old.
Shit from the 70s. One
you know
that
what,
looks like my father drove.
You know what we're starting to think, though? That, the whole time, like, the. You know how, like, the girls, the twins, were dressed in, like, the 40s and 50s outfits?
Mm-hmm. Maybe they were in Ravenswood.
Maybe they, that would, be how old the girls are now if one of them was alive. Miss Grunwald's age.
That's a possibility.
Think about it. Okay, has anybody ever seen the movie Pleasantville? With Toby Maguire, right? Think that's who it is?
Yes.
Toby Maguire? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Toby Maguire and
Reese
Witherspoon.
Reese Witherspoon.
Pleasantville much? Because everything's pretty much in black and white and like slate gray and everything like that. And the roses are in color and he's chopping the roses off the thing. Like,
What the hell was with that whole gathering around the angel statue shit?
It almost seemed like it was something that they did every day. Yeah, like, and then, a ritual almost.
And then poof, there's Shauna's ass once again. I can't stand her.
What did she have in her hand? That's what I want to know. She was carrying something in her hand. It was something violin. No, it was something red.
She was wearing red.
No, but it was something red inside her hand.
Who knows? Maybe it was Redcoat's arse.
Okay, so Grunwald.
Since we can't curse on YouTube.
Frying her hair off in the Mason Marjorie.
Marjorie, yes.
Marjorie, whatever it was.
Maison Marjorie.
Maison Marjorie. In that little salon as she's frying her hair off. I thought that Grunwald was supposed to be a B-I-T-C-H. Because she was very polite.
She was very nice, actually.
I'm sorry, I don't know who you're talking about.
Granted, she was lying straight out of her freaky eyes.
That's
Emily.
What'd you say? Infertility?
Immortality.
Oh, I didn't hear
Emily said that in the weasel-faced episode.
Yeah, that's immortality, my darlings. And then she says, I'm not who you think I am. Really? That's funny, because you look just like her. The episode's back on now.
Yes, it is.
Finally, we got some November weather.
Yeah, seriously. That is November in P to the F in Pennsylvania.
Yeah. Got leaves rolling around.
Blasting around, wind picking your hair up, wearing coats. I was like, yes, finally.
That creepy little guy that...
The bearded dude?
Yeah, that had a flip phone.
Yeah, the flip
phone. Circa 1990. Man. That little phone. That phone was funny.
You're funny.
So yeah, the music rings, people gather, almost like it's an everyday thing.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what are they going to honor?
Like, did you mean why is Shauna in Ravenswood?
Yeah, what did I put?
Why is Shauna in Rosewood? Why is she in both? Why is she transferring to Rosewood High other than being
Why is she even in the show?
No, I understand. Why is she anywhere? I said this at the beginning. I can't stand her.
Dude, seriously, she has had absolutely nothing to do with this whole entire show since season one. And I understand that they bring new characters on and
well, they could bring that bitch right off because I can't.
But the thing is, so this is the only character that they've really brought on 3 seasons into it that actually has some involvement in what's going on. And I don't like it.
And who the fuck are you? Like, get off the show, you bitch.
Nobody likes her. I don't like her. I can't stand her. I don't like her.
And if anyone out there does, stop watching this goddamn channel.
If you guys saw last week... it was either last week or the week before that the Ravenswood pictures were posted where Spencer's running around the corner. We called it. I knew it was Jenna's car. What? Whether Jenna was driving or not? Don't know, but we called it. Mike, that was totally Mike that smashed that kid's car.
And I was rooting for him the whole damn time, too.
Yeah, get it.
Yes, get it, Mike.
He had a Sharks hoodie on. So, he put Liar on the side of his car. He told Arya he was going to get him back. He was going to take care of it. Yeah. Ezra knew what happened, too. It could have been Ezra.
Yeah, but Ezra was standing around the corner looking in the window.
Yeah.
I still think it was Mike.
He was in the area. It could have been either or.
Whatever. I still think it was Mike. Likewise.
Poor Ashley.
Mm-hmm.
Getting arrested and stuff. It's sad. I don't know. We saw the previews for the next episode. They're sneaking in someone's house. I don't even know what the hell they're doing. But, I don't know. Pretty much it. Or are you not going to talk?
That's it.
I know that's it.
What else do you want to discuss?
Oh, that's it. Let me know how you guys feel about the episode. I didn't think it was that great. I was, like, super excited. Like, I wasn't disappointed with Ravenswood, don't get me wrong. But I was just expecting a little bit more.
And what exactly... I'm guessing that the strangest moment in Liar history must have been that whole gathering around the angel shit. Because I can't think of anything else, because why is a bird smashing into the window?
And people getting arrested on the show is not strange.
Yeah.
Finding out, I don't know.
I don't know.
Maybe the strangest moment on PLL history was that Hannah's dad actually felt some kind of sympathy for his daughter. Maybe that was shocking. Because it shocked the hell out of me. Asshole. I can't stand him. Yeah, sorry this video and the last video, the one that we filmed before, was not that entertaining. Because there wasn't really much entertaining entertainment value to this episode.
Really?
I'm feeling kind of like, this is supposed to be the season of answers.
Where are the answers, and why does that bitch keep showing up?
Oh, let's talk about Emily's mask person.
Oh, now that.
That was creepy.
That was super creepy.
That was creepy. Not gonna lie. Guilty.
Who the hell was that?
Like, no offense or anything like that, but the detective is really, either this detective is going along with everything, or she's super dumb and doesn't know how to be a very good detective, because why the hell would Emily, why would that disc that she sent was obviously of Emily standing there with the guilty sign next to the Rosewood population. Why would Emily write that out and put that on her desk? That's just stupid. Obviously she's being framed. So why is that detective even going there with Emily? You know what I mean? Why is she making it seem like Emily sent that, put that on her desk herself? Why? I don't
know. If she thought it was a joke or something, I mean, that was pretty damn stupid. Who the hell? Not to mention the fact, why would Emily be wearing an Emily mask?
That's what I'm saying. Why would Emily send that about herself? Like, why would she put on an Emily mask?
It's obvious you could tell that it's an Emily mask. It was an Emily mask! Hello! Which, Emily's beautiful, but her masks are scary.
They are. I think Emily's mask is creepier than Allie's.
Yeah.
Especially at the end.
I'm telling you, it's that freaking Hector / Bruce. That creepy-ass freaking freak walking around dressed in a red coat, cross-dressing, and doing all this shit. I'm telling you. That creepy son of a bitch. Something's up with him, and we're going to see more of his ugly ass in the future.
Unless he's dead.
Ooh, maybe he's dead, yes.
Dun, dun, dun.
Dun, dun, dun.
I don't know.
They'll find him with a pig shoved up his ass.
I'm just getting really bored. It's like, you know, no, I'm saying, like, you know how, like, they do that, like, the filler episodes and everything like that? I just feel like, since the first episode, that's how it's been. The first episode was freaking phenomenal. And after that, it's just kind of been like, meh. I was really looking forward to tonight's episode because we get introduced to Ravenswood. Now,
I wasn't disappointed by Ravenswood.
Oh, I wasn't disappointed by Ravenswood. I didn't.
Yeah. I really cannot wait for Ravenswood now.
The thing is, though, like,
maybe we'll get some answers on staring at the angel.
Yeah. Like, clearly nobody's talking in that town.
So yeah, seriously. How are they gonna get answers? They try talking to that lady with the two kids, and she blew them off as if they were ghosts.
As if they weren't even there.
Or were they ghosts?
All I know is that
it is supposed to be a
paranormal town. I wasn't disappointed with the Ravenswood. I'm just disappointed in general. I just feel like every episode is just getting more boring.
Either we're
going to
get blasted in the face.
Next week's episode looks pretty good because I'm super excited because freaking Caleb and Toby team up.
That is going to be epic.
Their little bromance.
That little bromance.
But watch, it'll be a freaking 2-minute scene and then we're going to be like,
they'll be like, yes! And then it'll be over.
Peace.
Bye.